What's going on, everybody? How y'all doing today, man? I'm doing good. Doing some traveling right now, you know what I'm saying? Gonna go take care of some business. I made a great deal last night, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna talk about that here in a minute. But I just wanted to wrap with you guys real quick. I got some things on my mind that I wanna talk about that I think that need to be talked about, that need to be looked at, you know what I'm saying, rather closely. Okay, because everywhere I look, this is happening. Let me tell you guys something, bro. I grew up like many of you modern young men out there today and young ladies out there today. I grew up just like you. I grew up where my father wasn't around, okay? Now, do I know the whole story behind exactly what happened? No, I don't. But here's the point. The point is, my father wasn't around. Now, as I look around society, I look around my family, I look around my friends, I look around the people I went to high school with, I look around the people I went to college with, and I notice one thing, bro. And what is that one thing that I'm noticing? I'm noticing that all these people that have these so-called families are growing up in society without their dads, okay? They're growing up in society without their dads, all right? And I'm gonna give you an example. My mom grew up without her dad. Now, he was widowed to my grandma, okay, but because he passed and lost his life, right? But it still doesn't discredit the fact that she had to grow up without a father. And there was a lot of detrimental damage that happened to her growing up without a father. My mom used to tell me all the time how much she loved her father, how she used to like to talk to her father. And guess what? She wasn't allowed to do that. She was only allowed to grow up with one side, okay? One side of the parent, okay? Which is the female, all right? And my mom ended up growing up, okay? End up having kids, okay? And the only person out of her kids that had kids was me, okay? Now, how's this correlate? What's going on? Well, let me go a little deeper. I happen to be experienced growing up, okay, growing up right now with my kids, my kids are growing up right now without a father, okay? I'm experiencing that, my kids are experiencing that, okay? Now, I go and look at other people's families. Let's go take a look at the last three women I've dated. How about that, right? I can't be wrong if I can just go look at the last three women I dated and I look at their households and let's see what happened. Well, the last three women that I dated, guess what? They all grew up without their daddy in the household, okay? Whether it was a divorce, whether he just wasn't there, the fact of the matter is the detrimental damage that happens to children when one or the other parent is missing, okay? I know society likes to make us think that one side is greater, because when you go to family court, basically what they try to do is they try to make one of the other parents look like a parent that's not capable of parenting. So they're able to give the name, the term of custodial parent to a parent, okay? And from this is where they derive child support from, okay? Because now they split up the family and they've made it seem like one of the other parents has a problem, okay? And this is how the system starts, all right? But I can go deeper. I look at, like I said, my last three women I've dated all have had their fathers missing. And let me tell you something. You see this in the relationship, okay? You see this in the relationship. You guys, the most hurtful part about this whole situation is there's nothing but victims all the way around the board. Okay, there's nothing but victims all the way around the board to what society has done. Okay, basically what they've done is they've played us. They've played us to our wants, our needs, our selfishness, our greed. All right, and they've given us an opportunity. They've given us an opportunity to make a choice. Do we want to have family, or do we want to have nice materialistic things in this world? And I'm sad to tell you that majority of these people have chosen the material things in this world instead of the family, okay? All of the people I know, okay, except for a couple of, maybe like two or three people I've known, everybody I've met have grown up without a father, okay? And you look at these people, you look at these people in their lives, you look at how they are, and you see one common thing. And what are you seeing? Well, they're repeating the same steps that their family did. So they're repeating the cycle all over again. This goes for the women I've dated. This goes for friends that I know. Now they're repeating the same harmful cycle with their families and their children. So where am I going with all this? Guys, at some point, someone's gonna have to wake up and understand, okay? And understand where damaged people come from. Damaged people come from damaged family homes, okay? And this is what you're gonna get when you have one parent trying to dominate raising children, okay? Another thing I want you guys to think about that's very, very important, I want you guys to think about, it's very, very important, is parent alienation, okay? Parent alienation. You guys, I'm experiencing this, okay? And I know many of you guys out there are probably experiencing the exact same thing, okay? And this is very, very unfair, and this is a strategic tactic used against one or other the parent, okay? This is happening both to the male and the females, okay? But I'm speaking more for say on my part, okay? Because it's happening to me. If you guys don't know what parent alienation is, it's basically what I've just explained to you. The courts have gone through and they've given one parent more power over the other parent by labeling them a custodial parent, which in the state of Washington, in the state of Washington where I'm in, that happens to be the women, okay? It's what they call a so-called woman's state, okay? So 9 times out of 10 here, you're gonna have a woman as the custodial parent, okay? And this could be even if she's not fit. Give you another example. You guys already know that I was a single father for years, okay? I was a single father for years before unhappy women seeing that I was successful wanted to bring me down and no longer wanted me to be able to carry that label because I was bleeding an example for many men around the world, and we can't have that, you know what I'm saying, in this feminist society. We can't have that. You know that. You can't have a strong man being independent, which he already is, okay, raising 2 children, okay, by himself. You know you can't have that. So if you guys don't know what happened to my story was I had 2 women going against me while I had these kids. Instead of supporting me, I had 2 women going against me trying to pull apart something that I was trying to make work, that I got put into position, okay? I got put into this position, okay? I got called by the courts one day and I got asked if I wanted my daughter, okay? So I went and picked up my daughter. And able to take my daughter, I had to take another child, okay, which was her brother, okay? No, it's not. He's not my biological, but it's mother. So children, I did this for years, okay? And unfortunately what happened to me is, like I told you guys, I had that time, I had two women coming against me that literally ripped that situation apart. Okay, literally. I was in court, having a woman coming after one of the kids, okay, that I got legally. Okay, tell me that's not fucked up. But this is what happened, okay? So where am I going again with all of this, guys? It's showing you the damage that is being done to our children based off of a selfish, greedy system that manipulated our women. The government, Big Daddy government coming in, all right, giving them all sorts of resources and all sorts of benefits if the man is not in the household. Okay, I saw this firsthand, you guys. I saw this firsthand, all right? And now I'm giving it out with my own two, after my mom went through it, okay? After my baby moms went through it, after my other baby's moms went through it, okay? All my friends I know go through it. Why are we continuing this? Can someone please answer this question? Why is this cycle continuing to go? Where are the leaders that are gonna step up and end this nasty cycle that we're having here, okay? Because it's beyond repair at this point, beyond repair. We got mothers and fathers fighting against each other in family court, okay? Which eventually it comes down to money. Okay, it comes down to money now that they're not together. So now you're ripping the based on money. Guys, look, I understand there's all sorts of different variables that happen why people aren't together, okay? But it still does not make it okay for one parent to hold a greater power over the other parent, okay? Therefore, the children miss out on valuable teaching, valuable bonding from the other parent, okay? This is the problem, all right? And the women that I see are just sitting back in the driver's seat with their legs crossed. Why fix it? And this is why we are going to continue to have these problems. Guys, I told you to be single in 2021 for a reason. Because now, unfortunately, what we're dealing with is we're dealing with women using men, okay? Using men as a come up, okay? This is what's happening. This is what's being taught. This is what's being shown on TV. This is what's being showed on talk shows. This is what's being pushed by feminism, okay? Your baby, your child, okay? They're gonna part ways from you, okay? And then on the way out, they're gonna take resources from you, putting you in a hole, making it hard for you to succeed as a man, because this system is set up against you, okay? Now, are there some good women out there? Maybe so, I haven't met them. Maybe so. Are there women out there that are not taking advantage of this? Maybe so. I haven't met them, but maybe so. I hear people talking about them, but I haven't met them, okay? All the women I've met, okay, all the women I've met have a man, okay, that they're not with, that they have children by, all right? And that man is either absent and or paying child support, okay? And you're getting, like I said, a single parent in a society like this, with all sorts of influences, okay, raising your children. If this is something that you want to risk, gentlemen, okay, then I suggest you go cohabitate, I suggest you go get married, and I suggest you have children. Become a part of the growing statistic that they don't want you to know about, okay? Okay, you will be in and out of court. You will spend hours and hours and hours and dollars and dollars and dollars and stressful days on stressful days just to get a right that you should have without even asking. Okay? This is the truth. Now, guys, I'm not going to be on here very long because I'm driving, right? I want to tell you guys about a humbling experience that I had last night. Okay, I had a really, truly humbling experience last night. Let me tell you what happened. So, you guys know I work for myself. I've been killing it. I must say that for all the haters out there. Hi, haters. Eat a bowl, haters. I'm doing great. Can't you tell? Look at me. I got all my hair. Hey, look at this. I got all my hair. I'm not balding. I don't have a receding hairline. All you haters. You know who I'm talking to. Anyways, let me get back to what I'm saying. I went and made a deal. Okay? I went and made a deal, right? I drove out to Sandpoint, Idaho. All right? And something called me to go out there. Now, guys, understand. I told you I've been working for myself, and this is how I make my money. Okay, I go and I make trips that the average person don't want to make. Okay, I go and get the money, bro. I go and get the money. I don't sit on my ass and wait for the money to come to me. I don't go work for somebody else, right? Where somebody else is standing over me, where they're having all sorts of bad days and they're shitting on me, right? Making me feel bad, threatening me, possibly threatening my job, security, and all this and that. I don't have that. Okay, I get up when the fuck I want, which I'm an early bird. Okay. The rooster get the chicken, pimp. The rooster get the chicken, pimp. Okay, that's me. I'm up early, bro. Okay? When I work for myself, I take this job very, very fucking seriously. All right? As you can tell. All right? But I don't have that stress of having to go through the hoops, getting in your car, have to go to work and beat the traffic and get there on time. I ain't got to do none of that shit. I make more money than most of you motherfuckers. And that's the truth, bro. Okay, so I'm tired of people telling me and hating on me, telling me that I been should have just gone back and done this and done that. No, bro, it's not happening, G. I'm on a come up, bro. I found a niche, and I've been trying to teach you guys on how to get it. Okay, I've been trying to teach you guys on how to get it, bro. This is the fucking facts, bro. Okay, this is what I've been doing. Anyways, I drove out to Sandpoint. Something called me out there, bro, okay? This guy had posted a whole bunch of workout equipment, all right? Most of the shit that I couldn't even afford, okay? Most of the shit that I couldn't even afford, okay? Well, at least not wanted to afford. I had the money for it, but why would I want to spend that kind of money, all right, and sit on it to risk the flip? Like, the type of stuff that I buy stupid good deals that I know I'm going to make instant money off of. That's how I spend my money, bro. I don't go blow my money on big, stupid things, okay? Everything that I spend my money on, I make for damn sure that I'm going to get at least double or triple out of it. That's how I get down, bro. Okay? That's me. All right? So I drive out to this house, bro, right? Big ass fucking house, bro. This house was so damn big, guys. This house was so damn big, it went off the motherfucking GPS. I've never, ever driven to a place when I use my GPS and the house is off the fucking GPS. Okay, real talk. Now, when I'm pulling up to this big ass fucking gate, this person had like this big ass mural built. Like, I have a picture of it and I have a video of the person's house, which I'm gonna post later in a short video so you guys can see, because you guys know I don't lie to you. When have I ever lied to y'all? Come on. All right, so I'm driving in under this big ass fucking huge mural. I already know this person's got fucking millions of dollars, right? And I so happen to get lucky and always find these posts where I tell you all these rich people are always selling stuff. But let me tell you this, guys. This is the Most High doing this work, okay? The Most High is doing this work because I got so many people out there who don't want to see me succeed. At one point I had two baby mamas that were trying to ruin my life, bro. Completely ruin me. All right, I was homeless like I told y'all. I didn't have a pot to piss in, okay? I didn't have no motherfucking dollars, all right? And let me tell you, that shit has drastically changed. You guys seen what I've came up on. I've got vehicles. I've got fucking all kind of things. I'm about to get my own spot here real, real, real soon, okay? So my life has changed drastically, and that's all because I gave my life over to the Most High, and I told you I've been doing His work. I've been helping people for free. I don't charge money for people, for consultations, for people wanting to learn something from me, right? I don't charge nothing. I give all my shit away for free, and I've been paid back, and this is the proof of my story. So I get to this guy's house, right? This motherfucker had a ginormous house on the side of a fucking mountain with a view that you would not believe. I got a video of it. I'm gonna post the video eventually. Bear with me, all right? This dude had a big ass house on the side of a mountain overlooking like water, a highway, all kind of shit. This big ass beautiful house. And he lets me come in his house, right? And let me tell you guys something. At the very first moment I saw this dude, I was judging him. And this is why I tell you Most High and God work in mysterious ways. And the Most High is using me, and He showed me right here through this experience, okay, that He is real once again, and He humbled me at the same time. I'll get there. Just be patient. So I'm talking to this dude, all right? I'm walking up in his house, and I'm just looking at this amazing house this guy has. This guy is rich, okay? Amazing house this guy has, right? And the very first thing I notice about this guy is he's an overweight person, okay? He's an overweight person, all right? The very next thing I notice about this guy is he's wearing a Donald Trump hat, okay? A Donald Trump 2020 hat. This is what he's wearing, all right? I'm already starting to judge this motherfucker, right? And he's talking hella redneckish, right? And get this, you guys know how I've studied Freemasonry. Okay, I've showed you how to look at the hand signs, when these people talk to you and everything. The whole time this guy's talking to me, this is the way he's talking to me. He's making hand signs like this. He's doing shit like this. He has his hands in the pyramid when he's talking to me. He has his hands down in the pyramid. Dude, he's doing all of this shit. Now, the Most High is allowing me to see this because this guy doesn't know that I already know that this dude is connected in some kind of way. Obviously, this motherfucker has a house off the grid on the side of a fucking mountain, off the GPS. We're probably like at least a $50,000 wooden mural concocted over his driveway entering that bitch, okay? So now, what was I there for? Well, he had posted a weight bench, okay? He posted a weight bench, right? And you know that's what I sell is exercise equipment. So he posted a weight bench for a stupid, stupid, stupid low price, all right? This guy posted, he posted a $900 bench, not a rack, just a bench. It's a hoist bench. I bought it, it's at the house. I'll post a picture of it later. Bear with me. Anyway, he posted this fucking $900 bench for $75. Now, you gotta understand, this shit was over 2 hours away, so ain't nobody just gonna jump at this post, because most of the time, people make fake posts to try to make people lower their prices. There's all sorts of hustles when you're talking to an OG like me, because I've been hustling this for over 10 years. This is why I'm so good at what I do, because I know the ins and outs. Anyways, he posted this fucking bench, like I told you. He posted this fucking bench, bro, right? Now, this bench was $900 new. Okay, it's a hoist bench, it's a hoist waist bench. So I drove my ass out there to look at it. When I got into this guy's house, like I said, it was a $1 million house all day long. $1 million house all day long. Maybe not the house itself, but the property and everything included in there, that was a $1 million property all day long, and he told me at the end, and I'm gonna get there. So I look over at the bench, right? I'm like, damn, $75, this is all this guy wants for this bench. He doesn't know that I'm gonna turn around and sell this for $500 all by itself. I swear to God, I'm gonna sell the bench for $500 all by just the bench, okay? Now, he had some other stuff. He had an elliptical, he had a sick ass treadmill, he had a sick ass cross cable, like a $5,000 cross cable machine. He had all the shit in there. Now he asked me, what else do you want? And I looked around, and this is where God was testing me. Bear with me in the story, you guys. I'm gonna be putting where God tests me. I'm gonna be entering it every few seconds here and there. So this is where God started to test me. He said, what else do you want? Now, you gotta understand, I'm already winning, okay? Now this is where God was testing me for greed, okay? Pay attention. dummies. I'm teaching you game on how God tests you every single moment of your life and stuff like this in order to know that if he's going to continue to give you more blessings or are you going to become a greedy bastard, okay? So the guy asked me, hey, man, what else do you want? I'm looking around like this motherfucker already has this shit posted for highway robbery, okay? All the shit that he had posted, this is God doing this, I'm telling you. He had everything posted for highway robbery. I could have bought so much more shit, and I didn't because I didn't fulfill that greed. I said, bro, you know, honestly, I said, all I want, man, is maybe some extra weights because I didn't tell him I just sold that weight rack that you guys saw that I just sold for $1,500. You guys just saw that weight rack that I paid $700 for and I sold it for $1,500. Check the fucking post. You seen it. I already did it. So I needed some more weights. That was the whole reason of buying that bench. And this was the whole reason, bro, of driving out there. Now, he had some weights and a bar. I had just got rid of my shit. So I was like, damn, this is a fucking lucky ass run that he has these weights here. And he has them for a stupid low price. So I was like, yo, bro, I said, how much do you want for the weights and the bench together? Okay, because you told me it was $75 for a bench. I'm going to pay that no fucking problem. Okay, but how much do you want for the fucking weights? I was about to give this guy, he goes, how much do you think you should offer? I was already going to lowball the shit out of him, which I feel bad for. I already was going to lowball the shit out of him for $150 for the fucking bar and 300 pounds of free weights. Okay, because this is what he had. He had a fucking bar, a brand new bar, and brand new fucking 300 pounds of free weights, bro. Okay, shit will cost you $800, $700 minimum all day online. Okay, these are sick ass weights that he had, right? So I was like, I'll give you $150, bro, all right? And he was like, nah, man. He's like, that's not what I want. And I go, what do you mean? He's like, that's not what I want, man. He goes, I'll tell you what. He's like, just give me $75 for the bench and give me $75 for the fucking weights and you can have it. I stopped for a second and looked at this dude. I didn't say shit. I just stopped and looked at this dude. I was like, dude, you're gonna let me win like that, bro? You're really gonna let me win like that, bro? You're really gonna let me win like that? You telling me I'm about to make $1,000 right now off $150? Yes, this is how God blesses me. This is why you fucking haters, this is why you're gonna vomit on yourself, this is why you're gonna end up taking a gun and swallowing a whole bunch of pills and kill yourself over me, because God is really fucking driving my life and there ain't nothing you can do about it because I'm unstoppable, bitch. Understand that. When God is in your life, you are unfucking stoppable, nigga. I am unfucking stoppable. I hope you fucking haters choke on a fucking piece of chicken, okay? Real talk. Now, this guy gave me all of this shit, right? All of this shit, bro. I said, thank you very much. He said, what else do you want? Man, I looked around, bro. This guy had a fucking whole dumbbell rack, like a whole dumbbell rack with the rack from like 5 pounds all the way up to fucking, I think it was like 55 or 60 pounds, right? That's $1,000 right there for that rack, right? He had all these other machines. This is where God tested me for the motherfucking greed. I said, I only spent $150. I can make $1,000. I said, I can lowball this guy probably again and get one of these machines and make at least another couple thousand. This was the devil. This was the deceiver. This was the evil motherfucking Satan in my head trying to manipulate me after already God was giving me a great deal, okay? God was already giving me a great deal. He was saying, Darius, you're about to make $1,000. Get your ass up out of there and be thankful, okay? This is what the Most High said to me, and I listened to that voice instead of the other greedy motherfucking voice that was trying to tell me to come up, okay? This is what I did. So now, guess what? This is where the story gets the best. The Most High said, now I'm gonna show you your humbling experience and why I brought you here, okay? Not only did I'm repaying you, Darius, for everything you've done, all your good deeds. I see all the hate that's being brought against you. I notice that you don't get to see your children like you want to. I notice that all these people are against you for no reason, Darius, because you're a really good person, man. And when you have not chosen, like I told you, a side, you're either going to choose the light or you're going to choose the darkness, okay? And all the people that I've dealt with in my life, unfortunately, I've chosen. So you can take heed and you can change your life, okay? You guys have known as what's been happening to me, bro, okay? I've shared every moment of my life, and this is why I'm getting blessed. So, I chose not to take anything else from this guy, right? I said, fuck that. I'm not taking anything else from you, bro. I said, you've done a lot for me. And then guess what he said? That almost threw a dagger to my heart. Guess what he said? He said, man, let me tell you something. He said, this world is going crazy, man. He said, God, he said the word God. Now you gotta understand, I already judged this motherfucker. Okay, let me give you another example. What does the news tell us about overshaped white people with money that are Trump supporters? What does the news tell us about white people who are out of shape, who are redneck talking, who are wearing Trump supporter hats? They tell us that they're racist. They tell us that they don't like black people. They tell us they don't like all of these type of people, right? Well, I'm here to tell you that God showed me something totally fucking different. And guess what the biggest kicker was out of this whole story? That the guy that I was talking to was a motherfucking transformer. He was a motherfucking transformer. Do you hear me? He was a motherfucking a real life transformer, guys. And at the same time, he blessed me. Well, God blessed me through him. At the same time, he brought up the word of God. And we started talking about God. He brought it up. I didn't say shit. And you want to know what he started to talk about? He started talking about how we're living in the end days. Guess what he's doing right now, you guys? Guess what this man currently is doing? And this is the reason he's giving all this shit away. You're right, he's moving. Just like I've been telling you, all this stuff that I've been buying from these people, all the rich people, take a hint, all the rich people, hello, wake up people, all the rich people are selling out, cashing out, and leaving the country. So what did he tell me that he was doing? He told me that everybody that where he lives on that mountain, except him at the current moment, has sold their house for double the money, okay? They have sold their house for double the money, bro, okay? The house that he bought, he shared with me how much he paid for his house, okay? Which most people don't do, but he did. And guess how much he paid for his house, ladies and gentlemen? $850,000 for this house he paid for. And guess what his broker just informed him that he's about to sell his house for, and now he's about to move to Costa Rica, okay? He was giving me all sort of game. He's about to sell his house for $1.8 million, okay? He's selling his house for $1.8 million, and he's buying a house in Costa Rica for $300,000. Now, let's do some math. This motherfucker's already set. He has a fucking career. He builds those wooden murals that I told you, okay? By the way, that wooden mural that he had in front of his house, guess how much it cost to build? $50,000. He builds those for a living, okay? And guess one of his top clients who he built for? ZZ Top, Disney, okay? He built for all of these people wooden murals of this size. So this guy has money. So do you think he's hurting off the fact that he's coming up on his house? He doesn't even have to come out of his pocket, bro. He doesn't even have to come. He's only gonna pull $300,000 out of the money that he get from selling his house, and he's gonna be banking on another
Yeah, one time I had like 25 deer right here in the winter.
Uh-huh.
I took this feeder out, and there was like 25 deer there.
Super cool.
Yeah, they come down in the winter.
I'm going to take a picture really quick.
Oh, yeah.
This is so nice.
Now that mountain over there, they call that Grief Mountain.
Which one?
No. Because the people back in the day, they went and dug all up in there for gold, and there's a lot of quartz, and usually you find gold with that white quartz.
Right.
And up on top, a guy told me that there's a mine shaft that has rails.
A mine shaft?
Yeah. And it has rails coming out of it, and there's like a little rail car, you know, wagon thing. And he told me that he was up there because he had to go up there for his job for something. And he told me about it. I was like, wow, I'm going to climb up there.
Did you ever go check it out?